flag officers and civilian leadership participating in the annual German Chief of Defense Capstone course joined Guam-based U.S. military representatives for an honorary wreath-laying ceremony at the SMS Cormoran II Headstone at the U.S. Naval Cemetery in Hagatna November 15. Joint Region Marianas Chief of Staff Captain Hans Schally retold the event surrounding the ship sinking in Apra Harbor during World War I and the death of seven German sailors who were later buried at the cemetery.
Low on coal, they sought refuge in a neutral American port. At that point, they came into Apra Harbor and requested from the naval governor a loadout of coal. And America choosing to remain neutral, they said, "We're not going to give you coal because coal was such a limited resource here, but you're welcome to stay." So for 2.5 years, Cormorant and her crew were guests here at the in Guam. And it was hospitable guests. There were parties thrown both ashore and on the boat. Many German sailors married tomorrow ladies and started families here.
In April 1917, when President Woodrow Wilson declared war on Germany, the commanding officer of Cormoran, Captain Adalbert Zuckschwerdt, decided to scuttle Cormoran rather than surrender. Learning of the plan to sink the ship, U.S. naval forces in Guam fired a shot over the ship's bow. This shot is considered the first by U.S. forces during World War I. The crew continued to scuttle the ship, and the subsequent explosion killed seven German sailors. The remaining German sailors abandoned the ship, were rescued by American sailors, and held as prisoners of war until their release in 1919.
I think it is a good tradition in our civilized cultures to honor those who have given their lives in wars or on behalf of their country. It definitely means that we are confronted with a piece of common history. We have to learn from the past and do better in the future.
For Joint Region Marianas, I'm Alana Chargulov.